Welcome to the Carrental Podcast, the only podcast that provides news, tips, and strategies for entrepreneurs and managers that want to grow and expand their business using MyRent. This is Mauro Chierugi, and this podcast is offered by Dogma Systems and MyRentSoftware.com.
Hi to everyone. Today we speak about car dealers. Yes, why a car dealer should join the car rental business? Well, the car dealer in most of cases are already doing the car rental business because they are providing courtesy car, for example, whenever a customer needed to repay his own vehicle. Or maybe they are providing test drive, for example, whenever a customer wants to buy a new car. Or they are providing cars whenever, for example, the customer purchases a car, is waiting for the arrival of his vehicle, or is signing a long-term rental, or maybe a leasing. In that case, the dealer would provide another car for managing the period in the middle. So, in all these situations, the car dealer is already doing the rental. But how well is managing this business? This is the crucial point, because everyone knows that the dealer has to do the renting, of course, but how well are we managing it? So it's very important. It's very important to have a system where you can check all these fleet, because you don't have only one fleet. You have multiple fleet. You have the fleet for the courtesy cars, and these cars are not the cars of that you provide for the test drive, for example. And you can have the cars for that you are providing to people that are waiting their new car from the car manufacturer. And what about the customer that would like to change the car for the weekend, for example? All these are mobility services and mobility needs that the customer today ask to the dealer. So let's look a little bit more into. First of all, if you want to join, if you want to make money with a car rental, you have to prepare a business model, a business case. You have to understand well what is the cost and the revenue that you will have, of course, once you will resell the car, because the car that you rent, at some point you will sell as used car to someone, and the car coming from the rent that the dealer manage, they have some benefit, because in general they have not many kilometers and they are quite new, so you can make the money, of course, with the rental as well as when you sell the car. If you purchase more cars, maybe not, depends by the agreement that you have with the car manufacturer. Also, this car for the rental usage maybe can be calculated in the discount and the commission that you negotiate with the car manufacturer that you represent. For doing well the business, however, there are a few things that are required. For make money, you need to have a business plan. You need to know the economics, what are the costs, what are the rates. And when we speak about the rate, of course, is different accordingly to the customer, because if we are providing a car for a courtesy, for a service, in that case, sometimes, in many cases, the dealer provide the car for free. In other case, instead, the car is not for free, so the customer will pay. And it's important to decide well, in this case, define, so also the person that at the desk know exactly how to manage the customer request, and when is the case to provide the car for free, and when instead the customer should pay. One more thing to consider is that when you provide the car, doesn't mean that if the customer has an accident with that car, also the damage was for free. No, of course, it doesn't work in this way. So the customer has to pay for damages, for his responsibility. And what you can do is to sell additional services also for the courtesy car. So, for example, in case of damage, the customer should pay €1,000. But if the customer purchase limited liability, for example, limited liability service, for an extra fee in case of accident, they can pay a smaller amount or nothing. Of course, the service will have different costs accordingly to the reduction of this liability. This could be an extra revenue also when you provide the car for free. And when you provide the car for free, there are some other additional services that can be sold, like the extra drive or a fee if the driver is younger, or a babysit. So we will not become rich with the courtesy car, but the service that we provide to our customer is very important, and also the limited liability could be an extra service that they are interested to. So it's important to take in consideration. Then we have the demo cars. Yes, demo cars, the test drive cars, in many cases we provide for free, but maybe the customer want to use the car for more days, and so it makes sense to rent the car, make them pay for additional day if they want to hold the car more, and in case of a purchase then of the car, we can also refund this rental. But in many cases also the customer want to rent for his needs. For example, he want to go 1 week in the mountains or to the beaches, and his car is not the right car for going there. So we can provide a car for the holidays, for the weekend, for a business trip. It's important in this case to be prepared and have a rate. Of course, the customer will search also in our website. So it's important that in our website there will be not only the activity for sell the car, but also for renting, because it's a service, a mobility service that the customer are looking. So if they will not find in our website, maybe they will find in another website. Is a trend that also that is very important, and I would recommend you to take in consideration, that is the monthly rental. Monthly rental, it's a trend now because many company don't want to do a loan for 36 months, for example, or 48, or a long term also, because they don't want to have constraints and they want to have flexibility. So they are ready to rent a car, for example, for 3 months, 6 months. And in that case, the dealer could be the right partner of these companies and provide a rental service that can last accordingly to the customer requirements. This is also a profitable business because the monthly rental is more expensive, has a higher rate compared to the long-term rental or a leasing. So you will have a margin, of course, if you manage well this business. And manage well will require to have a procedure written or implemented in a software. Manage the payment every month, manage the renewal of the contract, but a good software can help you in this. At the end also you will have your cars, the cars are used by employees or for the pool that are used whenever required. Also you can maximize these cars and make more profit selling rental days. So once you have analyzed these requirements and you have a business model, then of course you can start analyzing the numbers and understand if you can make a profit or not. It's important in this consideration that whenever you provide the car for free, you have to consider that you are not providing the car for free, but you are billing your car repair shop. Because in this case, the car repair shop is paying for the car. It's a service that they are buying from the car rental business unit. So it's not for free. Otherwise, you will consider the rental business as a losing business. Instead, it's the car repair shop that is consuming resources without a return. Take this in consideration when you create the business case. Then, of course, you will need a software, and the software should be able to manage this kind of rental, managing the different fleets in one place. That is important to have one place where you can see all the cars and manage the process for check-in, check-out, billing, and charging the credit card of your customer. You will need to prepare the contracts and the forms. You will need to inform your guys, your team and do some promotion internally, because the sales people also can advise their customer to try the car and rent for 1 week, for example. It's important to have a system to manage the credit card for the authorization, for the deposit, and for charging every month in case you want to do this business too, and manage and check, of course, the statistics, the numbers, the revenue per unit, the utilization of your fleet, so you can understand if you have too much car or not. So at the end, for the dealer, it's a business that is already doing, but maybe not managing so well. So take this in consideration, and moreover, don't forget to check the numbers, the KPI, and to analyze and check why you are providing so many cars for free to your customer. And this is not for free, but is a revenue for the rental business unit, and it's instead the cost of your car repair service. We know that the dealership will change in the next month, in the next years, and COVID, of course, accelerated this process. So be prepared for managing well your business. If you have any question, please contact us and send us your question in our podcast. We'll be very happy to receive your feedback, good or not. We can reply to your questions. And thank you very much again for listening. See you at the next episode. Bye.